everyone, Renee here. Today I'm going to work on the Feels Like Home scrapbooking workshop your way. It makes three layouts, so six total pages. It looks like a lot of fun. I love these colors. I love the whole farmhouse feel. I know it's really on trend right now and everyone wants to have, you know, Joanna come and do their house. Unfortunately, not all of us live in Waco, or not all of us can afford to have someone come and redo our house, so I thought it would be fun to put this together today. It's a nice spring day here in Tennessee, and it's feeling really nice outside, so was sitting outside for a little while, but now it's time to come in and do some fun crafting. So what I've got here is I've got all of the compliments already ready to go. I've also already cut out all of my pages using the recipes here in the layouts, and so we are just going to get started with making the first layout. Then this will be the second layout, and finally the third layout. So I will put some music on for you, and I hope you enjoy this process video, and I'll be back at the end to rehash any mistakes I made or anything I learned. And I hope you enjoy. so we are all done. There were a couple things I messed up on. I'm sure you saw. That's a usual thing with me, man. I don't know what I was thinking when I was putting everything together. And I had a little bit of a problem in the middle there with my filming equipment. So hopefully I am in the frame. I lost the app connection that I usually use so that I can see what's on my phone on my iPad in front of me. So hopefully this is in frame. If for some reason this is not in frame, I will go ahead and leave the speaking, but I will pop up pictures of the actual layouts for you. But here's the third layout. I really, really like this one a lot. We are going somewhere for Easter. So I think maybe I'll take a bunch of pictures of everything that's going on at Easter and use that for this because it's going to be together always, collect moments, not things. It just really lines up with what we're doing for Easter with some family. So I think that's what I'll use this for. So I'm really happy that I have some ideas. And have you ever had that kind of paper where you love both sides of it and you just went a little crazy because you wanted to use both sides? Well, that's this for me. I love both sides of this paper, so I'm really happy that we got to use it on this layout. So there's layout three. And then layout two, you'll see that I cut the wrong size, so I had to cut another one of the mats, but it was no big deal. I always have lots of black paper. You can use black paper for a lot of things. So I like this one as well. If you've been watching me for any length of time, you know we moved in October. So I think this might actually work well to take some pictures of us in our new house. I really think it'll work. I did change this. It said to use this lighter color, but the more I looked at it, the more I like the darker color against all of the white and the black. So I made a command decision and changed it. But I really like it. This says bless our nest. I'm not sure if you could actually see that. And that's what really got me thinking, this will be really good for our new house. And there are all kinds of pieces that I still haven't used. So like this moment might be nice. There are some other ones that are blank so I can put information on them and then put them on the page. So that's number two. And then let me grab the first layout, show you that one. I love this one as well. And I think it will also go along with some pictures here at the house. This particular layout in the beginning, if you were to follow the instructions, does not have mats for the pictures. What I used I can't remember the name of the paper. If you really need to know, leave me a comment. I'll let you know. So I went ahead and cut mats for all of these. Another thing that I forgot to do, and you saw it on the last one, was I forgot to do the fussy cutting out of this. This is that paper I told you I love both sides. But you were supposed to fussy cut out some of the roses. I think they're roses. If there's something else, please leave me a comment down below and tell me what these flowers are. I'm really good with vegetables, not so good with flowers. So I had to fussy cut one out, but you saw it didn't take any time at all. It was really easy to do. But I was supposed to put some of those on here as well. But once I got going on this, I was kind of like, you know, I kind of like it like it is. And I still have all these stickers. So I might use some of these stickers on these layouts once I get the pictures that I'm going to use. So that was everything for the, the Feels Like Home scrapbooking workshop your way. I hope you see that you can turn these into whatever you want them to be. You have a lot of supplies. I mean, there's some things I didn't even come close to using everything. Here's all the extra pieces. Let me just throw them up here and make a big old mess. And so there are all kinds. I love this. It says welcome home. I don't know if you can see that. I love this. I've got to find a way to use that. And I also have quite a bit of paper left over. So I can also do some layering. Like if I wanted to use this, it's kind of small, but I could use some other paper and I could layer underneath it. So that's some ideas that I have. I hope you enjoyed today. I'm really fingers crossed that everything stayed in frame once I lost my app. The app usually works great. Anyone who's curious, it's called A Power Mirror, and it allows you to mirror your iPhone to your iPad so you can see if you're using a setup like I have now where I don't have my mirror any longer, you can see if you're in frame. So probably wouldn't need it if you had a regular video camera and you had the flip screen and you could see it. And I may do that someday, but not right now. So I hope I stayed in frame. I hope you enjoyed it. Please leave me a comment. Subscribe if you haven't already. It would be awesome to get some more subscribers. I'm really excited. I think I just hit 230 subscribers, so thank you everybody. I'm really, really appreciative. And any likes that you can leave for me, any comments, any suggestions, things you want to see differently. If you know how to keep these things from clogging, you saw I used it and then it clogged just between two pages. So if you've got a secret, I tried, you know, tapping it and squeezing out the air, but yeah. So I hope you have a great day and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.